All right, so a lot of you guys have been asking me my thoughts about the firmware 6.2. As you all know, I've been testing it out since it came out last week, and I think today I'm ready to give you guys my pros and cons about this new firmware. Now, we're gonna start with the bad. The only problem I have with this firmware 6.2 is that BRAW Q0 has a little bit less detail than the Cinema DNG lossless. But for me, since I only deliver on YouTube, that's not really an issue for me because I can even tell the difference unless I zoom in DaVinci Resolve. Moving up to the good things. The first thing I like about this new firmware is the smaller size of the file size. Even at Q0, you can have a lot more recording time with this new firmware. Second thing I like about it, instead of having multiple DNG file or photos in a folder, you only have one file for the entire clip that you shot. Additionally, the firmware 6.2 BRAW has a smoother playback in DaVinci Resolve. I am using a 2-year-old laptop, which has a GTX 1070 graphics card, and I can get a 4K DCI. I can get a smooth playback in DaVinci Resolve. So the next thing I like about this firmware is the double tap zoom. You can do this via the button on the right of the camera, but with the firmware 6.2 now, you can just double tap the screen and it's gonna zoom in. It's gonna give you a 2x zoom that will help you focus. So the next thing I like about the firmware 6.2 are the different types of flavors you can record in. You can have Q0, Q5, different constant bitrate settings, and of course ProRes, HQ, and you can pretty much name it. There's a lot more options to record in with this new firmware. Verdict, I honestly think the firmware 6.2 is a really good addition to the Blackmagic Pocket 4K. We just really have to give Blackmagic Design some time. BRAW is not even a year old yet, so there's definitely more room for improvement. But at the same time, I think people are really forgetting how much this camera is. It's honestly $1,300. That's like a 4.7 touchscreen from Red camera. But if you don't like the 6.2, just make sure you keep both of the installers, 6.1 and 6.2, because you can actually revert from the 6.2 to 6.1, 6.1 to 6.2, as long as you have the installers in your computer. Like always, if you guys have any questions, let me know, and I'll see you guys later.